What's up, y'all? It's Limits Tune back again with another video. Remember, there's no limits to the limit you set yourself. Now, as you can see, there's a big ass gaping hole in the middle of my dash. I have no head unit and also don't have any speakers in the front nor the back. So, today I'll be installing the whole entire sound system. And a sound system consists of a head unit, 6x9 speakers, and 6.5-inch speakers, which is specifically for 1996 to the 2000 Honda Civic. Alright, so for this install, you need either a double DIN head unit or a single DIN head unit, depending on what you prefer. 6x9 speakers for the rear, 6.5-inch speakers for the front. You need a wiring harness. This wiring harness is really important because it'll make the head unit installation a lot easier since it has color-coded wires while the original harness doesn't. Soldering it, cutting it up, and taping it up is going to be a little bit more difficult because you can't just simply match it up to color like you would if you used to buy this harness so that it'll be able to match. But yeah, besides that, you also need a double DIN installation kit or a single DIN installation kit, depending on what you prefer, to be able to put the head unit into the climate control bezel and have it actually properly fit and not be falling over place when you're driving. For the tools, wire trimmers, clippers, whatever you like to call it, a Phillip, and wire connecting assortment, which is like little nuts and stuff that you can use to connect wires by twisting them together for better connection and so that it doesn't ground out or blow a fuse. All right, so what I'll do first is, of course, remove the climate control bezel because I'm gonna need that to be able to install the kit to install the head unit. So therefore, in my case, I could just pull it right off. Wow! Just like that, because it's not screwed in like it usually would be if it was stock. But that process is pretty easy. There's some screws around the dashboard, pretty much around the climate control that is connecting from the trim into the climate control. Remove that, it should be able to just take the whole thing out. But honestly, the climate control is gonna be a lot harder to take out if you have all the stock radio and everything in it. But even that process is easy. If you need a full tutorial on that, just look online, it's everywhere. I'm gonna take this climate control, I'm gonna bring it upstairs, have it set up on my desk so I can install all of this with good lighting, everything, so you know exactly what I'm doing. But yeah, let's get into it. All right, what I'm gonna start with first is connecting the wires. So you can simply pull off the wires from the head unit and start connecting the wires by color. So everything's all set, everything's all connected. Let's start with the next step, which is installing an installation kit into the climate control bezel. You're not gonna need no nuts for this. You're just gonna need a Phillip. All right, so let's grab the bezel. Let's grab the head unit installation kit. Pull everything out. All right, that's everything for the installation kit. Most of these installation kits come with a manual, and it's really important to have one of these because it makes the installation process a lot easier. 99 to 2000 Honda Civic. So from what it's saying, you only need the clips B and H on this main piece right here. You only need B's and H. So everything else, you can pretty much break it off. So what you can use to break those off is you can literally use this to clamp it off. I'm gonna break the ones, all the ones on the side. And this trim piece is gonna go right into there. It's gonna pop into place. Everything fits perfectly fine, but we're gonna have to pop it right back out. We only did that to see if it fits properly. To pop it right back out, you want to adjust the clips for it to come out easier. The pieces we're going to need with this is these two and this big one right here. So as you can see with the head unit trim, there's two holes right there. What you wanna do is grab the bottom bracket. And it got two holes also. You want to place it onto the holes and then screw it in with the hardware that was given to you. Screw them together from the bottom, just like this. All right, so now that the two brackets are screwed onto each other, what you want to do is you want to grab the side bracket, which is this right here. If you look on one of the sides, you can see a letter indicating if it's the left or the right. This one's the right. So it's gonna be positioned like this. But before doing that, let's break off all these brackets that we don't need, because once we install the double din installation kit, it's not gonna be able to go through the climate control. So you have to pop all these off. Make sure you be careful. You don't wanna actually break the bracket itself. Snap off the clips. This is for the right side. The right side will be over here. As you can see, this is two little pieces with the little space in between them. It's supposed to slip right onto the bottom bracket. Make sure these two mounting locations for the screws go right behind the double din trim. And then once you do that, pop this piece onto the bottom bracket. That is on. Same thing for the other side. I already popped off all the tabs. So now the installation kit is completed, let's check how the double din fits. It fits in just like that. I forgot to mention, pop these clips at the bottom of this too. I popped these two already. I'm gonna pop off the third one and then I should be all set. Just gotta slide it in just like this. Be gentle with it because it is all plastic. So now that the kit is all in place, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna actually slap the head unit into the installation kit and the bezel. On a head unit, you got these holes on the left and the right side, and it's supposed to mount with this bracket right here. And as you can see on this side, there's a climate control unit that's in the way. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna unscrew that, pop that out real quick just to install the head unit. Some clips holding it in. It's actually held in by three screws. I took the three screws out. Now you can pop it out. There's two screws that come with the installation kit. Just find out which is the best mounting location for you and just screw it in yourself. All right, it's nice and tight. It's not going nowhere. Now let's slap the climate control back in. Alright, so now that the head unit is securely mounted in the installation kit into the climate control bezel, let's bring the entire assembly downstairs, slap it in the car. Let's go. Alright, to start slapping the whole assembly into the car, there's four harnesses total. So these harnesses is for boom, this, and this, which is the climate control and the hazards. This right here is for the antenna. This wiring harness is for the head unit itself. So you just start connecting everything. So this wire is for the hazards. Can't reach it right now, so I'm gonna just do everything else that I could reach. Now let's connect the head unit harness. That's connected. So now the head unit harness is connected. Head unit turned on. Let's connect the antenna now. This goes right here. Now you can put this one in. As you can see, it's working. Boom. Easy peasy lemon squeezy, kid. Yes, sir. Finally got a head unit. Yeah, it's looking good, yo. I'm not used to having a head unit. But yeah, it works, but there's no point of it if I don't got no speakers in. Since I don't got no speakers, it's not gonna play nothing, so let's slap the speakers in. All right, climate control bezel and head unit is completely in, secured, working properly. What I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna slap the 6x9 speakers in the rear. There's four mounting locations, four screws. So I'm gonna need 8 screws in total for the 2 6x9s. All right, let's get into it now. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually push the chair forward so that I'll be able to access this easier and plug everything in. These are Kenwood's KFC X698. And if you got a crossover like this, that's how you know the speakers are pretty good. Got a big ass magnet, so it's pretty heavy. Just like that. So you want the terminals facing towards that way. So there's the terminals right here. You want it to face towards outside of the car. Alright, so this screwdriver is way too long, so I need a screwdriver that's like half of the height. So I was able to find a way shorter screwdriver. So both speakers are all set. Now let's connect it.
So to connect it is pretty simple. And you gotta connect the big one to the big one, the small one to the small one.
All set. Now let's do the fronts.
All you gotta do is just pop off the cover. And then what you wanna do is test fit it first.
Test fit it. See if it would like fleshly mount into anywhere. Because this panel originally already has mounting holes. Boom. There's three. So there's one, two, three. And the speaker doesn't seem like it is lining up with these original OEM mounting points. And I do see that their holes already drilled for me. And it looks like it lines up. So what I'm going to do is just, I'm going to use a Phillip. I'm not going to need no drill or nothing. But let's just say that I don't have those holes already drilled for me. What you have to do is literally drill your own holes, because the OEM speaker is really small, and even the mounting points of the speakers are small. So even though the speakers are still 6.5 inch, the bracket itself is smaller, so it will be able to fit the OEM. But since the Boss speakers I have a larger diameter mounting trim, I'm gonna have to mount it further out. But before drilling everything in, of course you got to connect the terminals first. Big one, big one. And small one, small one.
I need to calm down.
Adjust the holes to align to each other and start screwing it in with a screw and a Phillips. Alright, it's in now. Just two screws. It's really nice and tight. It's not gonna budge at all. Let's clap the cover back on. These are like hook clips. So what you want to do is slide that part in first, kind of hook it in, and then you pop all the other clips back in. Just like that. Now it's completed. Let's do the other side. All right, same process over here. Just pop it right out. All right, all set. Now let's test out the speakers.
All right, all the speakers are installed. Head unit's installed. I connected my phone via Bluetooth to the head unit. Now let's play some music and see how it sounds. I'm gonna play some no copyright music so I don't get copyrighted. Hit me with an ad. Yeah, that just sounds pretty damn good. Especially for right now. I'm planning to definitely upgrade the whole entire sound system again, like the speakers, rear speakers. I'm planning to put a subwoofer and everything. I already got it, just not slapping it in yet. This is just the start, but I'll be upgrading pretty soon. But just this as it is sounds pretty good, pretty quality, sounds loud enough.
All right, y'all, the whole entire sound system installation is complete. Everything sounds good, everything sounds on point. So yeah, we're pretty much all set. I'm definitely planning to do a lot more to the sound system of this car, but right now this will do. So yeah, whoever's watching, liking, and commenting under my videos, I appreciate a lot. Any support is appreciated. And if you're a new viewer, please like and subscribe if you're enjoying this kind of content, you like to follow the journey. I have a lot of content and uploads coming up soon. Yeah, that'll be all. See y'all next time.